In our fast-paced world, stress can seem part of everyday life. And recent Bupa research showed that 2 out of 5 people, that's 44%, currently feel stressed. Stress can be a very positive part of life. If we didn't feel any stress or anxiety, we probably wouldn't do many of the things we have to do. The problem comes if that level of stress is sustained for too long. So it's either too high and or it continues for too long without a break. The persistence of stress is very important, and the Bupa research has shown that slightly over a quarter of people report the stress persisting for over a year, and it's this persistence that can have a negative impact on health. Stress originates in a very primitive and quite basic mechanism to fight and flight to avoid danger. And what happens is if you are exposed to some sort of threat, there is an outpouring of hormones, and it's a quite complex mechanism, but it optimizes your ability to run or to fight. It was clearly very helpful if you were trying to escape thousands of years ago from a saber-toothed tiger. It's less helpful and adaptive now if you're trying to deal with your line manager in office. Stress can affect people in a whole variety of ways. Firstly, it can affect your thinking. So people find it difficult to concentrate, they can to worry and ruminate over things. And the problems with concentration can affect short-term memory. They become quite forgetful. It can also affect people's sort of feelings or sort of emotions. So people can be sad or irritable or more emotional. And finally, it can affect people's physical state, so they can get physical symptoms such as, you know, tummy pain, tightness across the chest, perhaps difficulty swallowing, headache, a variety of things. So stress can affect people in all sorts of ways, covering from thinking to body. If those signs and symptoms continue and become persistent, you would then develop a sort of mixed anxiety and depressive state. And if that continues, people then move into clinical depression or another clinical anxiety disorder. If you have that persistent stress, it causes a persistent elevation of a number of hormones, things like cortisol, and that's implicated in a number of quite serious physical health problems. For example, heart disease, hypertension, obesity, diabetes, reduced muscle mass, reduced bone density.